So this is chapter 7, hésiter. So don't forget, in French, we don't pronounce the H. So hésiter. Chez le fleuriste, that's at the flower shop, keeper, shop seller, fleuriste, the fleuriste. At the, it's a person's place, so we always use chez, like chez le docteur, chez le dentiste. La fleuriste. Féminine, Louis. We're not gonna say Louis, but we're gonna say Louis. Bonjour monsieur, je peux vous aider? Oui, je voudrais un bouquet, mais je ne sais pas trop quoi choisir. Vous voulez mettre combien à peu près? Je ne sais pas, peut-être 15, 20 euros. Regardez, on peut faire un bouquet rouge et blanc, c'est très joli. Ou alors, vous pouvez aussi choisir un bouquet tout rouge. J'hésite un peu. Qu'est-ce que vous me conseillez? Ça dépend de la personne. C'est pour offrir? Oui, c'est pour ma grand-mère. Alors, je vous conseille un bouquet de roses rouges. Vous croyez? Oui, vous allez voir, votre grand-mère va être très contente. D'accord. Hello, sir. Can I help you? Yes, I would like a bouquet, but I don't quite know what to choose. You want to... So, we saw this before. With a guy trying to buy a fountain pen, it's in the previous chapter. Instead of saying dépenser, which is to spend, you want to spend how much in a sense? What's your budget? We're not going to use this verb, we're going to use to put. Okay? It's a tiny bit less direct. So you want to put how much? More or less. À peu près, more or less. I don't know, maybe 15, 20 euros. Look, we can make a bouquet, a red and white bouquet. It's very pretty. Or, so you, it's like or so, you can also choose an all red bouquet. Okay. I hesitate a bit. What do you recommend? Conseiller means to advise. It's trying to make sense in English. So what do you recommend? It depends on the person. C'est pour offrir. Another thing that is really hard to translate in English is like, it's to offer. Well, basically, when you go to a store, people will ask you, especially during the holiday times, is it a gift? Do you want to offer this stuff? Is it a gift? So this is what we're going to mean, but it's not a literal translation. Yes, it's for my grandmother. So, I recommend to you, it's like a red rose, it's like a bouquet of red roses. Okay. Vous croyez, croire is to believe. But we're gonna say, do you think so? Really? Yes, you're gonna see your grandmother is going to be very happy. Is going to be very happy. Okay. So the present tense of savoir, to know, croire, to believe, vouloir, to want. Je sais, tu sais, il sait, nous savons, vous savez, ils savent. I know, you know, informal. He knows, we know, you know, group of people, informal. They know, masculine. Je crois, tu crois, il croit, nous croyons, vous croyez, il croit. I believe... I think so, it depends the context, hein, but I'm just translating the literal sense here. You believe, he believes, we believe, you believe, they believe. Je veux, tu veux, il veut, nous voulons, vous voulez, ils veulent. I want, you want, he wants, we want, you want, they want. Vocabulary, vocabulaire. Aller chez le ou la fleuriste, masculine, féminine. To go to the florist, okay? Faire un bouquet de fleurs, c'est to do and to make a bouquet of flowers. Un bouquet pour offrir, pour moi, pour un mariage, pour un anniversaire. It's a bouquet to offer, it's a gift, for me, for a marriage or for an anniversary, a birthday. Une gerbe pour un décès, la mort de quelqu'un. Décès is the death of somebody. A gerbe is, you know, this kind of a crown or special flowers you buy. Fond de tune. Quelques fleurs, a few flowers, les roses, les tulipes, les lys, les marguerites, les orchidées, les iris. not going to translate everything because I'm not really a flower person. So roses, tulips, marguerite, you saw the lilies, I guess. I don't remember. You saw in the meadow, you can find these white flowers, orchid, etc. Une plante à fleurs, le géranium, le camélia. It's a plant, it's a flower plant. Une plante verte, a green plant. Arroser les plantes avec un arrosoir is to water the plants with a water pitcher. Je ne sais pas, I don't know. Je ne sais pas trop, I don't quite know. Je ne suis pas sûr, I'm not sure. Peut-être, maybe. J'hésite un peu, I hesitate a bit. Vous croyez? You believe so? Do you think so? Really? Now the exercises. Vrai ou faux? True or false? Louis ne sait pas comment, combien il veut dépenser. Il ne sait pas exactement combien il veut dépenser. Louis doesn't know exactly how much he wants to spend. Exactly, he doesn't know. It's like 15, 20, he doesn't really know. So, c'est vrai. It's true. La fleuriste propose un seul bouquet. She proposes only one bouquet. C'est faux. Louis veut donner les fleurs en cadeau. Louis wants to give the flowers as a gift. C'est vrai. Il achète des roses. C'est vrai. He buys roses. C'est vrai. Savoir, croire, vouloir. It's just a matter of practicing and to learn here the different forms. Je ne sais pas quoi choisir. I don't quite know what to choose. Bénédicte va adorer ce bouquet. She's going to adore this bouquet. Tu crois? Do you think so? Tu veux acheter des fleurs pour tes amis? Do you want to buy flowers for your friends? Vous voulez faire les bouquets? Or vous voulez, c'est pas faire because we don't have this opportunity, this option here. Vous voulez? Yeah. Vous savez, do you know how to make the bouquet? Non, je ne sais pas. So, vous savez. Vous voulez que je mélange les roses et les tulipes? Do you want, vous voulez, that I... No, that I made a mistake here. So, it's like, vous croyez, it's like, do you believe, que je peux mélanger les roses et les tulipes? That's a weird combination, actually. It's like, do you believe that I can mix the roses and the tulips? Oui, je crois que ça va être joli. I believe that that's going to be pretty. Nah, I don't know. Elle ne veut pas aller chez le fleuriste aujourd'hui. She doesn't want to go to the florist today. Il ne sait pas combien il veut mettre pour cette gerbe. He doesn't know how much he wants to put on, to spend for this crown, this, you know, funeral bouquet, I guess. That is a game you can do if you want, if you feel like it. You know, it's gonna take a long time to correct this, but anyway, we get the main idea of this dialogue. And the grammar, which is conjugation, actually. You have a nice day, and I will see you very soon. Au revoir. À très très bientôt.